going on?
We're currently in August. It's the middle of the fucking summer. Satan's ball sack is sitting on our heads. And yeah, just working through life. This is one of the few things I've ever found in my entire life that's always a challenge, that I am never good enough. Like, it's like, all right, that looks cool. I bet I can do that. I'm like, oh, self-defeat. I tried and I failed. Do it again. Do it again. Do it again. And then eventually you're like, oh, I got the rhythm down. And then you move on to something more dangerous and more terrifying and more like you might almost hit the ground, but you don't.
Fuck it. I'm just gonna, you know, stay home today.
We're doing this. You have to reach up high if you want to do it here, or you can start from the ground to separate the fabric. Kick away. Awesome.
Bye. Later.
Ladies and gentlemen, last month, me and Lenny went head-to-head in an extreme drunk match. What you may or may not know about me is that I have crippling alcoholism, and every match is an extreme drunk match, everybody! Guys, I don't remember much about the Lord of the Rings, but I do know that Lauren looks like a hobbit, and Jeremy looks like their feet.
Well, first and foremost, we would like to say congratulations to Lenny and Cameron. Big round of applause for these guys. They have a new sitcom starting this fall on ABC where they play two wacky, mismatched roommates, you guys. It's called We Can't Live Near a School.
Both Laura and Jeremy are the type of people that are really hard to tell how old they are. Like, I have no idea if they're like 25 or 45. But I do know that regardless of age, they definitely have multiple sets of the Harry Potter books at their house. Like, I can just imagine them, one of them saying, you never know when we're both gonna want to read The Goblet of Fire at the same time. Better get two copies. Like,
they always knew they were destined to be together. They have so much in common. Like the same parents.
At the end of round two, with a score of 8, the Martin Duprass, and a score of 10, the Heavy Metal Mafia.
That's hilarious.
This is gonna be a nice wheat beer with lemongrass and ginger.
Hey, if it turns out bad, man, I'm sure some other people. I want it to be like a little more, you know, aromatic and almost kind of elegant, not so savory and punchy.
I'll say playing music is a lot like brewing beer in the fact that it's a weird amalgamation of who you are and what you like. and a way of sharing it. Like, I love Irish red. I love red beer. I like dark beer, and I like sharing that with people. And if you think of like music, it's kind of a slower, more melodic tune versus a lager or an IPA, which is a little more hoppy, a little more poppy. It might be more like jazz music or rock and roll music, something like that.
That's nice. Doing that thing.
My lens is all fucked up now. Oh, I fucked up. Nora. Yeah, my vlog. This is our Airbnb. This is how big it is.
You're the worst. Who brought it? James, why'd you bring a camera?
I'm going to put on some makeup and then probably change my outfit because I'm kind of undecided about this. Do I look like I wouldn't narc on you for smoking weed in this outfit?
There's so much comedy coming up. Here we are. Here we are. We made it. Get in.
What's up? My camera.
We're going to be at Blue Whale Festival. Oh, wow. My face looks well done.
Fuck off. Let's go.
Hey! Whoa! What are you doing? Get it out! Get it out! Who are you? What are you doing? Hey! What is this
site? What shows are we on tonight?
Start with Jamie. Sound Pony!
Honest to God, the best wings you'll have in Tulsa.
Having fun so far?
Alright! Toss up, make some noise! Woo! There it goes! Hey, I'm a hypnotist! Man. Chase me!
Decided to not chase you.
Years, but before that, I opened a gas station. A lot of my customers really happy when I moved to this location. They bring the whole family, like more room, more table, more Chinese, more busier now. So my mom family have blood Chinese, and my father family Indonesian. Yeah, we mix my experience from sushi restaurant, and then mix with the Indonesian ingredients.
Mike Allen eats miso, a short film by James M.
There's like cinnamon in here or something.
Yeah, I can taste something like that. The soccer roll's really rocking me. Now I got a lot of work done today. I was just like on a roll. Now I'm on a roll again. Start tonight, I'm talking over. Bow golden bows, that